Ever wanted to tap into the raw power of Google's latest AI model, Gemma 3? Stick around and we'll show you how. In this video, we're going to demonstrate two different ways to get started using the online version. See our previous video on how to use the local open source version on your own PC. Link in the description below. First, we'll dive headfirst into the intuitive playground of the Google AI Studio website, where you can chat, create, and even have a conversation with any of the brand new Gemma 3 models. No coding required. But that's just the beginning. Then we'll take the next step and unleash Gemma 3's potential within an example Python script, showing you exactly how to bring its intelligence directly into your projects via a clean and simple API. Whether you're a beginner, curious about artificial intelligence and natural language processing, or a seasoned coder looking to leverage the latest LLM technology, get ready to unlock the impressive capabilities of Gemma 3. Okay, let's get started. First, we go to the Google AI Studio website, make sure we are in a chat session, and choose the model we want to use. If we wanted to do some image processing, we would need to select any model larger than the first one. The selections we are making today are free, but are limited. We choose one of the medium-sized models, the 12B version. 12B means 12 billion parameters were used in training the model. Next, we type in a question for the model to answer. We will be using a math quadratic equation example, which should give us two answers. We ask for a step-by-step solution that we can follow along with. The first step is to put all terms on the left side, setting the right side to zero. This is correct. Then we have three options on how to solve. This is also correct. The quadratic formula is the most common and straightforward solution. This is the most correct. We can see there are three terms, A, B, and C. This is correct. We take these three terms and plug them into the formula as shown. Correct again. Then we solve for the two values, one with addition, the other with subtraction. This is correct. Finally, the two answers it gave us were correct. The model scored 100% on this example. By the way, you can keep track of your free credits below in the tokens count used versus available. Now onto the Python code example. We will need an API key. This key can be used for any Gemma or Gemini models that are available. Click on the Get API Key. Then click on Create API Key. A pop-up form shows up. Copy the value to the clipboard. We will be using that later. You can view the billing plans here, showing the free versus paid plans. Now we are ready for the script. We need to set up an environment using this YAML file. There are only two packages required under the dependency section. Run the conda create command. Then, when it's finished, run the activate command to start up the new environment. This is the code we will be running. This is a simple example just to show how to get started. We will be creating more advanced videos for using models like Gemma and ChatGPT in the future. Now back to our code. We import the Google Gen AI package and the OS package. Here we get the key from our OS environment settings. You could just paste it in here for a simpler, less secure method, but we suggest using the environment settings for any production applications. Next, we create a new Gen AI client, passing in our API key. Next, we run the generate contact function for models, passing in the model name and our question. Finally, we print out the text portion of the response. Now let's run the script. This runs fast and gives us a simple response that looks correct. Let's test another math question. The answers are correct and the steps are shown. Finally, we give it a coding debugging question. It found the typo or syntax error and gave us the correct fix. There you have it. Now you have two different ways you can go to include Gemma in your daily workload, making your job simpler and more efficient. Stay tuned for more videos on AI with more complicated questions and comparing some of the popular models to see which one is winning the race at the time. Okay, that's all we have for today. Thanks for watching our video. As always, questions and comments are welcome. See you next time.